हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, मायसेल्फ श्री डीके कमलाकर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर फॉर कॉमर्स इन सेंटर फॉर डिस्टेंस एजुकेशन, शिवाजी यूनिवर्सिटी कोल्हापुर. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न टॉपिक नेम्ड अकाउंटिंग फॉर लीज, विच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक फॉर एमकॉम पार्ट 1 सेमेस्टर 2 हैविंग अ practical problem of a 16 marks or maybe asked in a short note also. So already I have given my introduction, so today we are going to start directly to the topic. So in lease accounting we need to understand a theoretical aspect like meaning, definition, features and types of lease. So let's begin with meaning of lease. Lease is an agreement by which one party, that is owner of asset, gives the right to use an asset for a given period of time to another party, that is user of asset, on a rent. So the owner of the asset is called lessor and user of the asset is called lessee. It is not a sale or purchase transaction. Lease allows to user to use the asset for a specific period without ownership of an asset. Let's understand the definition of lease. The lease is a contractual agreement between lessor and lessee where the lessor allows to the lessee in return for a payment or series of payments the right to use an asset without ownership for an agreed period of time. Let's understand the features or characteristics of a lease. Lease is an agreement between two parties, that is a lessor and a lessee. The lease agreement is for a stipulated period of time only. The lessor gives the right to use of asset to the lessee. The title of asset, that is ownership of asset, remains with the lessor. Next, the lessee makes the regular payment of the rent to the lessor for the use of asset during the contract period. The maintenance and obligation for asset assumed by the lessor in short-term lease and lessee in the long-term lease. The tangible, movable or immovable assets are subject to lease, that is machinery, equipments, vehicle or premises, etc. Lease decision is a financial decision for a lessee and investment decision for a lessor. Let's move towards the types of lease. There are major two types, financial lease and operating lease. Let's understand the what is financial lease. Financial lease is also as a capital lease, long-term lease or close-ended lease. A finance lease in which all the benefits and risks of ownership of an asset are transferred substantially to the lessee. The holder of the title may be the lessor. It is non-cancelable lease in nature. The lessee is responsible for maintenance of the asset leased. Operating lease. The lease which is not finance is an operating lease. So operating lease is also known as short-term lease, service lease or open-ended lease. It is a lease which does not transfer substantially all the risk benefits incidental to ownership of an asset. Such a lease agreements use the right to use the leased asset for a limited period of time. The lessor is responsible for maintenance, insurance and all other relevant expenditure of the asset. The risk of obsolescence is borne by lessor. The lease is cancelable in short notice by the lessee. The asset leased out may be used by a number of users in sequence. It is suitable for computer hardware, trucks and automobiles, etc. Let's understand the next part, that is difference between financial lease and operating lease. So by way of points, first point is lease period. Financial lease is long-term lease, whereas operating lease is short-term lease. Maintenance of finance lease borne by the lessee, because it is a long term, and maintenance of operating lease is borne by the lessor. Specificity: the asset leased out is used specific for a lessee. That asset is prepared for the or purchased for the lessee. In operating lease, the asset is leased out may be used commonly by number of users in sequence. Ownership risk: the lessee bears the risk and rewards associated with the use of the asset leased. The operating lease: the risk and rewards associated with use of the asset leased is borne by the lessor. Obsolescence risk: the lessee bears the risk of obsolescence in case of financial lease. In case of operating lease, the lessor bears the risk of obsolescence. Cancellation: financial lease cannot be cancelled because it is a long-term lease, whereas operating lease can be cancelled. Payout: in financial lease, it is a fully payout lease where a single lessee repays the cost of asset with interest. Whereas operating lease, it is a non-payout lease as the lessor is in the business of leasing the asset to various users at a several times. This is all about theoretical aspect of a accounting for lease. Next part is, today I got a question paper of December 2019 of MCOM Part 1 Semester 2. Question paper code is SH28. I have taken a lease problem from that question paper for a solution. Okay. So let's understand with an example or a practical problem the lease account. The Fair Leasing Limited, problem is here. The Fair Leasing Limited leases an asset to Messrs. Bharat Traders under the following terms. Cost of asset is Rs. 1 lakh. Term of lease is 4 lakh, 4 years. Residual value, that is scrap value, is nil after 4 years. Statutory depreciation is charged 40%. Lease rental is fixed rupees 35,740 payable at the end of the year. Implicit rate of interest is 16% per annum. And inception of lease, that is starting of a lease, is 1st April 2010. Give journal entries in the books of lessor. This is a problem and they ask as a solution, give journal entries in the books of lessor, where the Fair Leasing Limited is a lessor and Messrs. Bharat Traders is a lessee. Let's understand the problem. Cost of asset is 1 lakh, lease period is 4 years, and residential value is nil and depreciation charge is 40%. And lessee gives a yearly rental to the lessor is ₹35,740 payable at the end, and implicit rate of interest, outstanding amount worth the interest is charged by lessor to lessee is 16% per annum, and lease is going to start on 1st April 2010. And they ask as a solution, give journal entries in the books of lessor. Let's start with solution. Here, in this type of a problem, we need to make a one working note, that is calculation of interest, where 4 years calculation is there, as already I have shown in the PPT. End of the year first, that is 2010-11, payment got to lessor from lessee is 35,740, and principal amount that is recoverable for lessor is 1 lakh. So on 1 lakh is outstanding on 1st April, so full year interest, that is 16% on 11 lakh, interest will be 16,000. It means whatever payment received from lessee, 35,740 minus 16,000, remained as a lease charge 19,740. Are you getting me? Sir, 35,740 paiki 16,000 bha ha interest bhag hai, rahilela as a principal amount aplela milela. It means at the end of the first year, 80,260 will be the remained principal amount. Okay. At the end of second year, that is 2011-12, again we got a amount of ₹35,740. So now interest will be charged on amount of 80,260, and that comes as a 16%, 12,842. It means out of 35,740, interest will be 12,842. It means we got as a lease amount, lease principal amount, 22,898. So at the end of second year, the principal amount is remained as 57,362. So at the end of third year, again we got a rental, that is 35,740, and we charge a 16% of interest on 57,362, that comes 9,178. It means 35,740 out of interest part is 9,178. It means we got a principal amount of ₹26,562. That is 35,740 minus 9,175 is equal to 26,562. End of the third year, we remain only principal amount is 30,800, and at the end of the fourth year, we got a rental of ₹35,740. Out of that, principal amount is 30,800. It means remained part as received as interest, and that is 4,940. And this is at the end of the fourth year, the asset will be remained nil or zero. So this is a calculation which is very important for this type of a sort. But the next part, that is journal entries in the books of Fiar Leasing Limited, that is lessor. So first journal entry in the books of lessor will be, this is on 1st April 2010, the lessor will purchase the asset. So asset account debit 1 lakh to payment, that is to bank account 1 lakh. So asset purchased by cash or by bank. Okay, that is being asset purchased by the lessor. That is a narration. Next, at the end of the first year, that is 31st March 2011, that is rental receivable from the lessee for use of asset. So journal entry will be रेंट रिसिवेबल अकाउंट डेबिट 1 लाख, 1 लाख रुपयाचं रेंट येणार आहे कशाच्या बदली, तर असेट गिव्हन आहे, सो टू असेट अकाउंट, असेट दिलेले, सो असेट गॉन, असेट इज असेट इज अ रियल अकाउंट, व्हॉट इज गोज आउट, रियल अकाउंट रूल यू हॅव, यू डोंट यू नो डेबिट व्हॉट कम्स इन, क्रेडिट व्हॉट गोज आउट, सो असेट इज गोइंग आउट, सो जर्नल एंट्री विल बी रेंट रिसिवेबल अकाउंट डेबिट 1 लाख टू असेट अकाउंट क्रेडिट 1 लाख. एट द एंड ऑफ द फर्स्ट इयर इंटरेस्ट रिसिवेबल एज रुपीज 16,000, सो इंटरेस्ट रिसिवेबल अकाउंट डेबिट टू दॅट इज एक्सपेंडिचर, so to interest 16,000, that is interest journal entry, and the first year, at the end of first year we got a rental of rupees 35,740, then the entry for this is bank account debit to rent receivable actual principal amount, that is bank account debit 35,740 to rent receivable account, that is principal amount 19,740, and remaining amount, that is interest receivable account 16,000, being rental received, is a narration for this journal entry. Next, end of the second year, again interest receivable account debit 12,842 to interest account, that is 12,842, so it is interest receivable, being interest receivable from lessee. So next, that is actual rental received, so bank account debit 35,740, out of this to rental as a principal amount received, so to rent receivable account 22,898, to interest receivable account 12,842, being rental received from lessee. Next, end of third year, again interest due, that is interest receivable account debit 9,178 to interest account 9,178, being interest receivable or due. And next entry in that year, so amount received, that is bank account debit 35,742 as a rent receivable account 26,562 to interest receivable account 9,178. So narration is being amount received from lessee. And that is last year, fourth year, journal entry of end of fourth year, 31st March 2014, is interest receivable account debit to interest 4,940. So that is interest due, for interest due. And last entry, that is amount received at the end of the fourth year, so bank account debit 35,740 as interest, as a rent receivable account, so to rent receivable account 30,800 to interest receivable account 4,940. Friends, this is journal entries in the books of lesser. So only journal entries are given here. They may ask journal entry in the lessee also. Here no question of depreciation journal entry is here in the books of lesser, because in the long term lease or finance lease, the charges is maintained by or borne by the lessee. So lesser is not charging the depreciation and other expenditures. So also ledger accounts will be also, they may ask. So I will try my level best to give you another example with ledger account or lessee in the books of lessee, ledger account or journal entries. Still time, this is enough for today's lecture. We will meet again for next lecture. Okay, if you have a queries, then please contact me. Your queries will be resolved as soon as possible. Queries and doubts are welcome for myself improvement. So please WhatsApp me on my mobile number 973 000 5683. Thank you for watching my videos. Please subscribe my YouTube channel, The Tatre Kamlakar, or please give reference to BCom, MCom, MBA student to subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you very much.